Welcome to K-Rigg It. I had some comments on my last video asking about the homemade press brake that I have here. It is a 40-ton press brake that's 60 inches wide. Basically, the frame is all made from leftover materials that I did for a job on some roof trusses for actually my parents' house. And so it literally was built from 2x12, I think quarter inch thick, uprights, and the cross beams are, I believe, 8x6s, 3/8 inch thickness on that. And then I added that A-frame at the bottom with an adjustable screw to try to keep that bottom surface as flat as possible, because it will bow down when it's under the complete tonnage. The top die is literally some straight dies that I welded to a fixture that came from the belay metal brake that I don't use. I use the finger die the most. And then the bottom dies are just a four-way V block that I bought off eBay, off a person off in Florida. And it's two pieces of, I think it's like 39 inches long that I had to cut one down a little bit. But the neat thing about this is I've set it up so that it is controlled by a PLC, and this is your actual activation of the rams, and this is your set point. So you basically set, it's just a counter, and you set a certain number, and I've kept up with like a 2-inch V, which is the 2-inch bottom V, for 90 degrees on steel and lev gauge. I know I have to set this number to 150, and basically what I've done with this is I've had enough inputs to this that I can have two set points. So this is the first set point, that's the second set point, and it sets it here. And then you can activate this one. And then if you have a tube bend job, which I've really never used this, it's always just been, I've just done one bend at a time. But if you did, had a piece that needed a bend and then the second bend, you can program each way. The return springs are just gas springs. They're about 4-inch travel, 80 pounds a piece. And, I got those off Amazon, and they're pretty affordable. They were, I think, only like 12 or 15 bucks a piece. So with four of those, you have enough lifting power to return all this back up. And then the position is literally just, it's kind of hard to see, but this part right here is a linear potentiometer that I think is maybe 100 millimeters long, that comes from the slides on mixing boards for like music. And you can get those on Amazon for, I think they're like $7 a piece. So basically all this PLC is doing is it's putting a voltage to the potentiometers here, and then that's how it knows how to level it and then go to the set point. So what I'm going to do here is turn these, and then basically I don't have a set point, but I'll show you how it levels and then goes down to your set point. Really, that's it. So pretty simple, pretty straightforward. And Works really well. I like the fact that it's not as fast as like a hydraulic or a mechanical press brake. It's a little bit safer. And I've also thought about putting switching these out to a foot switch because it does get handsy where you're trying to use two hands to hold the material, and then you have to come over and hit that switch. But other than that, it bends 6 foot of 10 gauge easily. I haven't done anything thicker than that yet. I have done thicker, but not as wide. So, thanks for watching and subscribe for more.